It's been a year since COVID-19 shut down much of Massachusetts, and while communities closed, research was and still is in full swing.
We very much are learning in real time. There's never been a situation like this.
Dr. Daniel Koritzkis is chief of infectious diseases at Brigham and Women's Hospital. He says one of the biggest questions surrounds immunity. According to the CDC, getting COVID-19 may offer some natural protection. Evidence suggests reinfection within 90 days is rare. And in January, a promising study found lasting immune response up to 8 months after infection in 95% of people who'd recovered from the virus. But Koritzkis cautions the virus variants could impact this.
We know in South Africa that people who had natural infection could get reinfected by one of these new variant strains. So they may be protected for life from the original strain, but not from the newer strain.
When it comes to immunity through vaccination, researchers are focusing on the volunteers who participated in early stage vaccine trials about 10 months ago.
All we can do for now is follow how long their antibodies remain high and then later see whether any of those people might get infected.
Koritzkis says he expects we'll get an update in the next few months. In the meantime, work is also underway to figure out if people will need a booster shot or a yearly vaccination similar to the flu shot, and that depends on two factors.
One, how long does immunity last? Do we see these antibody levels begin to decline over time, and do they reach some level at which there's no longer protection? The second is, how important do the variants become? And if there's not good cross protection against the variants, you need to have a slightly modified vaccine the next time around.
So these answers to the questions really only come with time. In the end, Dr. Koritzkis said the goal of these vaccines is to protect people from getting really sick. And all three vaccines available in the U.S. are highly effective at doing just that.